in position. And look what I got here. I got me a sunken tree. And I got my little slab, baby. Any slabs? Whoa! Was that fast? Whoa! And we just started our day. It can't be. Could it? Really? Wow, eh? Look at that. Look at that. What a way to start. I said, doesn't matter. Rain, sun, wind. When you find the right spots, the right cadence, right presentation, right baits, little slab magnet, this is what you get. Right there, that's not gonna be our biggest fish of the day, but man, when you can start crappie fishing and catch a fish on the first drop, you're happy. I'm gonna put them right here. How about that, huh? Ready, crappie? Ready? Go on. That's a good eating size crappie, but boy, I came here looking for some hogs. You know those big, beautiful black and yellow ones and gold? You know what? I'm after it, man. And the watercolor, like I said, is like a tea color here. So I went to the bright chartreuse with some silver sparkle and a chartreuse head with a red and black eye. And the setup is real simple. For me, this feels like an extension of my arm. It's so light and so sensitive, and it has that little hole right there in the reel seat where the blank comes through. So it's like lightning, gone. Polaroid glasses, when you're fishing, brush an individual structure and cover where potentially you're only fishing below the surface. Even in tannic water like this, you gotta wear polar glasses to see not so much the fish, but your bait disappear. Let's see if we can do that about another 20 times. See that with the reel seat way back like that? Well, it doesn't bother you. And you're not worried about casting levels like that, but you just, there's a little dial at the side. They just loosen off for pulling out some line, tightening it up for your distance for your jigging. And so when I'm holding it, when I'm jigging it like that, and we're holding it in my spot, this finger is right there. My other hand's pulling the line out, and I slowly just drop the bait. I'm not casting it. I'm not pitching it. I'm just slowly dropping it above that cover, and I'm holding it. And once in a while, that's it. That's it, just like that. Hardly shaking it, hardly shaking it. That little tail, see how in the wind it goes like that? So imagine underwater. I just barely move it, and that's all you want. When the fish are on that heavy cover like that, sometimes the least amount of movement is the best. I'm in their domain, remember that. They see it. Whoa, just another good eater, look at that, hey? Whoa, whoa, oh yeah, this one is definitely a keeper. Oh, lordy crappies, man. Crappie day. Look at that, hey? Beautiful crappies, man. Ready to do their business soon. Look where, how deep he's got it. When you get it in the top lip like that, 90 times, or 99% of the time, those fish are in the boat. It's nice. Let's put one in the box. Let's cull out. I guarantee I'm going to cull out these fish with some big plate-sized ones. Let's put you in there for now, okay, buddy? Here. Let's put you in here for now. Go on. Look at that tea color in there. You can see it. It's just off, like a tea. Like I said, do you spider rig? Do you pull cranks? Use a slip float. You know, all kinds of ways with different baits and minnows and worms and anything under the rainbow. But something about picking up my individual single pole. And in this case, for bigger bites, for crappie, it's so reminiscent of bass fishing. Nice and slow, stocking down, finding the cover, and then waiting for that thump, and then the magic starts. Let's go get some more. You just gotta work around the brush, find out where the edge is sometimes, and put it right on the edge, because it could be the, whoa. It could be the magic spot. Magically delicious. Wow, eh? I don't know if I'm going to spook them by letting them go. Just a starter. Hold on. Okay, and as for color of jig head, real simple. It's tannic water here. It's got some color, like a tea and stuff like that. So it's not crystal clear. I can sneak up on them still, put the poles down. But I want to see the jig heads pink with white with a black eye, and the chartreuse with the red with the black eye. pink or chartreuse, that's it. So important, even when you're on one little brush pile, one little beaver dam, or even a dock and stuff, how you move around and dissect the shallower stuff, deeper stuff. Is there a post? Is there shade? Is it drop off a little deeper? Is it go a little shallower? And I wasn't getting any fish going a little deeper, so decided to pull the boat up a little bit, went in tight and saw that little black hole, and right away, pow. And I changed it up to a little blue and green, almost like a bluegrass or something. Same chartreuse head so I can see it. Let's see if I can drop it down and catch another one right here in this old, decrepit beaver dam on the edge. Let's see. Come on, fish. Where are those big spooky ones? Come on, fish. In the hot spot? Is that where you are? You're chasing minnows? Come on. Got my line stretched out, my hand here, so I can lower it and lift it as I like. There's all those minnows again. Oh boy. You know that you got a good bait when you're fishing around live bait, schools of minnows, and you're catching them. Whoa, good one. And you're catching them on plastic, eh? Well, that's a good crappie. Look at this. Carl, get him in a boat. Wow, wow. That's a good crappie, boy. That's a good, good crappie. Look at that. Wow. Hold on, you. Mama and Papa says, bring home some crappie, Carl. We want to eat. Yeah, that's an eater. Mm-hmm. Let's put him in there. But this one here, 12 feet long, and if I have the bait all the way down, that gives me another 12 feet. That's 24 feet of pendulum in the holes, dropping it in close, this side, that side. And you'll see, a lot of times when I'm catching fish on the outsides and stuff, you want to move around a little bit. And sometimes they're just chasing the minnows or bait that's in that cover. So having that a little bit extra distance of the 12 footer give me 24 feet altogether all around, you can't beat it. Where you at, bad boy? Wow, a lot of minnows down there. I'm like little Elmo, in with all the minnows. Hoping to get bit. Trying to trick them when they can eat live bait. My artificial bait. All of a sudden it just disappears. And you feel that little electricity in the pole. Oh, it's a good one. Oh boy, look at this thing. That's just said, huh? You want a good one. Oh, yes. Look at that. Hi, crappie. Wow. Just finished saying, be a little patient, huh? Be a little patient. And get rewarded. Still not the giants, but that's okay. We're going to put a few in the box. I'm definitely going to have supper. But boy, we want to see the ones that just light up gold and black. Let's put them in there. Black chartreuse, one of the most popular colors of crappie bait. I don't care where you buy baits, what kind of baits you use. This right here, the black natural with the chartreuse, everybody uses it. Another one right here called the therapist. I told you, I'm gonna have some therapy today of crappie. This one's got that purple with little flake in there and the chartreuse little tail. That therapy, that's what I need right now. I need some crappie therapy. You gonna work for me? You better. And last but not least, you ready? The mermaid. You just see that? A lot of times they call it blue with grass or different things, or like a bluegrass. But this right here is called the mermaid. That's a good one. Look at that. You talk about spoof splash, boy. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? Oh, wow, look at this one, how he ate it. Look at this one. He likes the pink bubble gum, doesn't he? Pink chartreuse. He's a handful. Wow. He's a good one. He's a good one. They're all good ones, aren't they? But he is. Yeah, he's a good eater. He's a good eater. Come here, boy. I need to put that there, because if I put it in the water, it'll probably get eaten. That's a good one. As soon as you hit them, all over the place, like a little wild pig, you know? So 6 pound gamma, you can either use fluorocarbon. I like the monofilament because the water's got some color, but the 6 pound has got so much strength and abrasion, so you're not constantly retying. But when you're fishing anything, any kind of species near trees, concrete, whether man-made or natural cover and stuff, always check that last couple feet like that, because you don't want to be heartbroken when you get the slab of the year and your line breaks. Are they in tight? Look at this. Here we go, folks. Oh, there's a good one right there. Oh my goodness, Carl, what are you doing? I watched them, dude. Put it right back. Watch this, look. Just drop it down slow. Hold it right there. Here he comes. My goodness. Oh God. Yeah, man. Another good one. Look at him. And this one, I got the purple chartreuse. And the common denominator, man. Oh, another good fish. It's that chartreuse head. Remember, I want them to see it. I want to be able to see it. And you're single pulling like this, when you can just see your bait disappear, when you don't see those bites sometimes, just feel them. It's just incredible. Boom, how they can just suck it in. You know what? We got lots like that. Let's let them go. Ready? Let's put it right back in again. Fix my bait. Actually, it's pretty good. I can get a lot of fish with one bait, man. I just changed up from the black and chartreuse. I originally had straight chartreuse with silver sparkle, and adding some variety to my life, as well as the crappie, and put it back in here in the shallow by the tree. See if there's a big pig in there. And just hold it. One shake of the tail. Come on, crappie. Oh my goodness. Lordy, lordy. Lordy, lordy. Sure making my day, huh? Look at that. Just beautiful crappies. Come here, boy. I mean, there ain't nothing wrong with any of these, boy. On a slow day, man, these would end up in the live well and end up on your kitchen table that night. But for me, I'm just having a blast catching some crappies with a single pole. We're going to see you next time, right here, right now, catching crappies every which way but loose.